Ampetronic. Listen to the difference.
Hello, my name is Andy Jackson and I'm a system design engineer at Ampetronic. This video will show the steps required to carry out a metal loss test using the HLS-2D portable test amplifier and our Loopworks Measure app. For detailed instructions, refer to the HLS-2D handbook. As this is a small room with no concerns about overspill, we are going to be testing a perimeter loop. If you know that a multi-loop is required, for example to avoid crosstalk with adjacent loop systems, use a figure of 8 test loop instead. This is explained in another video. Start by laying your test loop using some single core cable terminated with the 4mm banana plugs. The loop wire should be as close as possible to the intended installation. For example, if you want to install in the ceiling, the test loop must be done in the ceiling too. Here we are just going to loop the seating area of this meeting room. Now the wire has been laid, we can connect everything together. First, plug the ends of the loop wires into the two loop output sockets on the HLS-2D. Next, plug in audio and power. A 3.5mm stereo audio cable is supplied with the amplifier to plug into a phone or an MP3 player. If you haven't already got the combination and pink noise test tones, they can be downloaded from www.ampetronic.co/signals. The amplifier also comes with a 12V mains power supply. However, here we are going to be using a rechargeable battery. A recommended battery specification is in the handbook, and this then allows fully portable testing without having to worry about power supply availability or voltage on site. Once everything's plugged in, turn everything on. Start the combination tone playing and make sure the power, input and current LEDs have lit up. In Loopworks Measure, create a project and system for the room you are testing, or select one that has been created previously. Press Start Test and choose Start Site Assessment Test, then give the session a name. Filling in details of the test loop, the HLS-2D is preset to 2.5 amps of current. The size and construction is important for later reference. Add a suitable amount of test points. We are using 3 here for a small room, as we will test the middle, corner and edge, but in larger spaces add more positions. For a perimeter loop, you should always test at least the middle and the corner, around 1 meter from the loop wires, as this will show the highest and lowest points of the signal. Select step 2 of the test procedure in the app. With the combination tone still playing in the room, stand in the position of your first test point and make sure this is selected. Making sure the R1 receiver is held vertically at 1.2 meter height, wait for a peak of signal. Press Save and OK to store the result. Move to the second test position, change the test point and save a second reading, then repeat for the rest of your test points. During the readings, you can ignore the pass or fail verdicts. We are not trying to commission a system to the requirements of the performance standard and would expect most results to fail. Change the signal type on your MP3 player or phone to pink noise and move to step 3 in the app. Save a frequency response reading. In each of the positions, you saved a field strength level. Again, don't worry if this doesn't show a pass. This is everything we need to do with the test loop, so turn off the power to the HLS-2D. Now the amplifier is turned off, we can record a background noise measurement. Move to step 4 on the app and repeat the readings at each of the test positions. In this step, we do want to see a pass verdict, as it is proving that the background magnetic noise level is low enough to make an induction loop system beneficial. If you are testing on a construction site with temporary power or generators, then the background noise reading may not be valid, as different electrical equipment will be in use when the room is finished. Once the background noise tests are saved, press the Stop Test button. At this point, the results of all your tests will be displayed, so they can be checked before leaving site. Now that you can review the results, if you have seen more than 6 dB difference between the highest and lowest readings, a perimeter loop installation wouldn't be able to meet the IEC60118-4 performance standard. In this case, if it would be possible to install a multi-loop array in the room, try carrying out a figure of 8 test instead. There is another video showing how to do this. All data will automatically synchronize to your Loopworks account if you have a data connection. However, if you are offline, then you can go back into the project view when you have a connection and manually synchronize. To review your results after leaving site, log into your Loopworks account, go to the project and system, then you will see the site assessment test session. Open this session and review the results. Again, remember that we don't need to worry that a pass verdict hasn't been achieved. Click Review and Edit to move the session off the app. Unless you need to add any comments, you can click Save Session straight away. You can also click on any of the verdicts to see the detailed measurement data. Once you are ready, you can issue the session or click Print Draft to get a PDF copy of the data. The PDF can be sent to Ampetronic or your local distributor for analysis, but you can also use the measurements directly in Loopworks Design. There is more detail on how to interpret your results in the HLS-2D handbook, but we can quickly work out how much loss we need to account for here. Start by creating a new perimeter loop design with the same dimensions as your test loop. Then go to the Outputs Variation tab and look at the base current value. We need to change manual adjustment until this matches the 2.5 amp current used on the test loop with the HLS-2D. We can use a dB calculation to work this out, or just trial and error. Here, minus 0.7 dB means we are simulating the exact same system as we tested in the meeting room. Now look at the levels on the coverage plots in the areas where your test points were measured. In the metal loss test, we saw around minus 3.5 dB in the centre and minus 6.5 dB at the side and corner. Looking at this simulation, we are seeing around minus 0.5 dB in the centre and minus 4 dB to the side and corner, so we have approximately 3 dB of metal loss. Now we know our loss figure, go back to the Inputs Design tab, choose Manual Loss in the Metal Type dropdown, and type in our 3 dB figure. Go back to the outputs again and make sure to reset the manual adjustment to zero or how you would like to optimize the system so we are simulating the correct level. Now the design will show the potential amplifiers that can be used for this installation.
Ampetronic. Listen to the difference.